Okay, so if you've been doing motion graphics for any amount of time, you are probably very familiar with parenting. You take layer one and parent it to layer two, and it will follow layer two's position, scale, and rotation. And by doing that, you have full control over the child layer. This is the parent layer, this is the child layer. So you can move your child anywhere you want, but whenever you move your parent layer, the child is going to follow. You can parent individual properties. If I want to take the scale of layer one and parent that to the scale of layer two, the scales will follow. However, position has no effect on layer one, and layer one's position has no effect on position of layer two. Same goes for rotation. So there may be times you want to parent only individual properties. There's something else you can do also. Say we take the position of layer one and we parent that to the position of layer two. And as you can see, they're right on top of each other. So if I toggle this off and on, you can see that. But now if you go to the beginning of this expression and you type value plus, layer one is going to come off here to the side. But what you're able to do, if you move this back up, the position of layer one will follow the position of layer two. But now you have complete control over the position value of layer one. Now you may be saying, well, why don't you just parent layer one to layer two? Well, because by doing it this way, you have also full control over the scale and the rotation, and they will move independently. So let me back out of all that. The point I'm trying to make here is there are several ways that you can parent layers. You can parent one layer to the next, and it will follow position, scale, rotation. You can also parent individual properties. In this case, we're doing transform properties of position, scale, and rotation. This would also work for opacity. So say if we took opacity and we parented that from one to two, whatever you do on two is going to affect one. But one of the things you may not be aware of is you can parent properties from layer to layer and then add in this value expression at the very beginning, value plus, and now you have complete control over the child layer, and you can do with it whatever you'd like. And now keep in mind, if you parent the scale of layer one to the scale of layer two by adding value plus, what you're saying is whatever the scale of this layer two, the parent layer, the scale of this is going to follow that. So we have value being 100 plus the scale of layer two. So if you want these to be equal, then you make this value zero. If you want to make it smaller, go in the negative direction. So negative 50 would make this scale of this layer 50. By adding value plus, you just get a different way of controlling your layers. And now you can also do this when it comes to using the time expression. So you may have used the time expression. It's usually used on rotation. So we can option or alt click onto rotation, type time times 150. And it just kind of gives our shape some speed where it's going to spin around. At the beginning of this expression, if you put in value plus, you can dictate where you want the rotation to begin, at what degree. You can also keyframe this. Put a keyframe here. We'll make this zero. Jump forward about a second. Jump a full rotation so you can get a fast spin, and then it will go back to the time expression speed of 150. So let's get rid of everything here. Then with our shape layer selected, let's go up to Effect. We're going to do Expression Controls and add a slider control. So now let's Option Alt click onto Rotation and type Value plus Time times. We want this value to come from our slider control. So this is your expression pick whip. Just go up to the slider right there. And if we watch it play back, we can see that we have no speed. And that's because speed for the time expression is coming from our slider, which is set at zero. But now let's go to about the 1 second mark and put a keyframe for zero. Go to about the 2 second mark and say we'll make this 150. Now if we watch it play back, we'll see that the beginning of the rotation has now been delayed. So this may come in handy if you have a need to use a time expression, but you want to control when that rotation begins. Hit U to bring up your keyframes. If we just kind of spread this out, we can see it's going to start a little bit slower and then eventually catch up to our 150 speed. One of the things I like to do whenever I use this expression is to right click on that second keyframe, easy ease in, and pull the handle all the way over to the left. It kind of comes in smoother and it gets to that 150 speed a little bit more evenly. So those are just a few different ways that you can parent layers. You can parent transform properties of specific layers. Don't forget to use value plus at the beginning of your expressions. So that way you can get a little bit more control over exactly what it is you're trying to do. And don't forget, if you need to delay the beginning of a time expression rotation, add in a slider control, add in value plus time times, and then pick whip the slider control, and then set those keyframes to the point that you want the rotation to begin.